Buzz, I'm hungry.
Okay, Dickel. I gotta go to Ace Hardware. So, there's some crackers, sardines, and one can of beer. Don't touch my Ruffles, my peanuts, my Zero Bar, or the beer that's in the fridge. That's only for me. You understand?
But Buzz! Oh my. That was delicious. Thanks for the food and beer, Buzz. Too bad I won't be here when you get back. There's my airport shuttle. Connecticut, here I come. You're such a sucker, Buzz.
Hello!
This is part 8 of this Fairbanks Morse series. Hopefully this episode will get the cabinet finished. I've yet to put on the trim. And these were the trims on it. They went here in the front and back. Got them marked. Front, rear.
Oh, brother.
So, these are going to have to be sanded down. There's a bunch of glue here. And, of course, this is all mismatched. What I think I want to do is... match this trim, this portion here, to this color, and this is going to be real dark. And I got some brass brads I think I'll use to put them in there. That might look pretty good. Well, there's those two trim pieces. I just sprayed some stripper on them, and I'm going to give that a few more minutes. Let's see how it comes off here.
You are watching a master at work.
Oh, shut up, you mouth!
That don't look too bad. Okay, I want this darker than here. Then, after I do this, I want this little strip here even darker. So I bought some of this Mohawk toner, a brown mahogany. I don't know if it's going to work. Let's just try it. What do I got to lose?
Light coats will evenly build and shift the color without covering the natural grain and look of the wood.
Now, the more you put on there, the darker it's going to get. I'm going to leave that set a while and do the other side.
For more information or to purchase the products you've seen on this video, please go to www.mohawk-finishing.com.
It don't look too bad.
Or call us at 800-545-0047.
Let that dry a little bit and then see if we got to put some more on there. Okay, here it is after a couple coats. Let me spin it around so you can see both sides.
You show off.
So like I said earlier, I'm going to leave it like that. And then I'm going to do the little trim part.
Okay, wrap it up.
I'm going to continue using that toner until it's a lot darker. And I think that might look okay. But who knows? Okay, I'm going to stain these trim pieces here. Now, I'm going to use the same special walnut that I used on the veneer here. I got a package in the mail the other day from Wifey from Arkansas.
Well, hi there, sweetie.
And she said that she's seen me use stain, and I like to use undies. So she sent me a pair of John's undies.
Ew.
And I'm not particular. I'll use them.
Yeah.
I think he had a bout of diarrhea on that.
Mr. Poopy Pants?
Don't smell too good, but it should work okay.
Oh, you nasty man.
Thanks, Wifey from Arkansas.
You're welcome, sir.
Wifey, she calls me jerk.
Not darkening that up too much, is it?
Could you get it just a little darker?
You just have to let it soak in there.
This pisses me off.
Let's see what size undies John wears a 36. 100% cotton, made in Canada. Oh, John, you're supposed to buy in American stuff.
So what?
Let's just put it on there real thick.
Report to me when this has been accomplished.
Alright, we'll let that soak in. Hopefully, it'll get a little bit darker. I'm going to do a couple coats on it. I'll show you the finished thing when I'm done. Well, it's about time to clean up these ugly wires here. And I'm going to redo these wires on the lights. I ordered some cloth wire, white and black.
It's a pain in the butt being politically correct.
It's kind of hard to get this stuff. It's 22 gauge cloth wire. Instead of that 20 gauge they sell at radio days like this. That's just really too thick. Well, I have the 22 gauge. So I'm going to redo these. Take my sweet time, and I'll show you what it looks like when it's done. Hot damn. Okay, I have applied some frog tape around the edges here because I only want to get this trim portion very dark. And the same on the other side. And I use this frog tape. You get the green stuff or this stuff. This is for delicate surfaces. It's laying on top of the toner that I put on the end here, so I don't think that's going to disturb it.
What plan will you follow now?
Plan 9. Can your heart stand the shocking facts about grave robbers from outer space?
Okay, I'm going to let that dry and then go over it again. And then I'll show you what it looks like when I'm done. Woohoo! Well, there's the new wire in there. Got rid of all this yucky wire. It's going to go in the trash.
Yeah.
This is for the voice coil and field coil. This is for the antenna. This black one's the ground, but they don't really need that ground, so I'm just going to tape it off and put an alligator clip here. So then when I want to play it, I can hook it up to my antenna on my front window frame. Here is the lights. I rewired it from here. This had a kind of like a fuse coil wire type thing, and it was kind of come out apart, so I put heat shrink all the way around here, so this is not going to short out it at all now, and it looks cute, I think.
It's so cute.
Well, let's take a look at it.
If you do not speak English, I am at your disposal with 187 other languages along with their various dialects and sub-tongues.
Well, what do you think?
Finding a mess like this ought to make anyone frightened.
I think this needs to go a little bit darker.
The darker the better.
But I like this. I like it.
I like it.
Now I've done something to the speaker wires here that I've never done before. I attached these connectors here.
How successful has it been?
And I did that because it's easier to test outside the cabinet without gator wires. Also, when this is bolted into the cabinet, and I need to take this out, all I have to do is unhook these connectors here. I just have to figure out a way to put them so they don't short out. You know what I'm saying?
No, sir.
if they're all bunched together, I can tie wrap them somehow where they're not going to be touching. So I thought that might work on this radio. So let's turn this radio on and see if it still works and play an old song. I'm game for that. Okay, I want to darken that up and brighten it up a little bit. So I'm going to use this sparingly. It's the same toner that I use on the outside edge. So let's see what happens. Oh, they're coming to get me. I think that it's going to do the trick.
Come on, man, out with it. We haven't got all day to waste.
Now I know you're off your rocker.
Let's get a shot of it outside so you can see it in a good light. Well, there it is. I think it looks pretty good.
Excellent, excellent.
I think it's gonna look good with the trim on here and those two other trim boards that go up here. The dial is gonna look cool on here. I'm going to have a nice reddish grill cloth for that. How about a round of applause for old Buzz here? I'm going to put these trims on here. And I'm going to use this contact cement again, because these are kind of, they're not quite flat. So here's the other one. This one's really kind of warped. Once I put the contact cement on there and keep pressing on it, it's going to stick like that. I'm not have to worry about clamping it. Okay, let's see if this thing works after all my wiring. Just want to make sure these don't short out here. Alright, I'm just gonna flip it on.
Fire it all!
General J. Connor, trusted with that task of providing electricity and the medications and the
food. Well, I'm happy it works. Sounds real good, too.
Or change of regime needed, hadn't even an office to work in, in January of 2003. So, preparation.
Let's play an old song, and you can watch me as I glue the trim on and have a good old time, shall we? Let's just tune into a nice song here.
Her sailor and he loves her too. Oh, bell bottom trousers, coat of navy blue. She loves her sailor and he loves her too. Oh, oh, oh. Once there was a little girl who lived next to me.
That's me.
And she loved her sailor boy. He was only three.
That's me.
Now he's on a battleship in his sailor suit.
Suit.
Just a great big sailor man, but he's just as cute.
Boot.
Bell-bottom trousers, coat of navy blue. She loves her sailor, and he loves her too. Oh, when her sailor boy's away
on the ocean blue,
soldier boys all flirt with her,
but to me she's true.
Though they smile and tip their caps,
and they all go boing,
she just smiles and shakes her head,
then she sings a song. Bell-bottom navy blue.
Navy blue.
I love my sailor and he loves me too.
Oh, 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 oh. Everywhere her sailor went, she was sure to go, go, go.
Till one day I sailed away where she doesn't know.
Now I'm gonna join the waves, maybe go to sea.
A bug.
Try to find her sailor boy wherever he may be. Oh, if her sailor she can't find on the bounding main, she is hopeful he will soon come home safe again.
So we can get married and raise a family.
Dress up all our kiddies in sailor's dungarees.
Whoa!
Bell-bottom trousers,
coat of navy blue.
She loves a sailor,
and he loves her too.
If you watched my last video, I showed that when I had this volume control all the way down, it was still blasting. And I got a comment from John from Arkansas, of all people. And he said, if you take a jumper and hook it up to the wiper, which it is right now, and go to the low side of the volume control, and if you touch it, means you short it out and you get no volume, that means the volume control is bad. So let's do this experiment right now and see if John from Arkansas knows what he's talking about. Now, his theory is true, and right now let's get a radio station. If his theory is correct, now I've got the volume all the way down. If his theory is correct and I touch the high side of the volume control, it should go all the way loud, right? Let's try it.
Who is this here?
Okay, now if I go to the other side, and if I touch this, and the volume goes away, that means this volume control is bad. Now, the other side of the wiper is connected to this wire right here. So, let's test this right here. Here we go. Well, I'll be damned. John from Arkansas does know what he's doing. I thought he was all full of... All right, John.
Best way to put this, sir.
You know best. From now on, I'll listen to you.
There you have it. I mean, it can't get any easier. It just cannot get any easier. Until next time, this is John.